Want to become an expert on navigating D2L content? Here's some great tips to help you get around each of your courses. After reading the announcements page in your course, navigate to the Content tab to see what your instructor has set up. If your course is completely online, chances are that your instructor has uploaded content and activities that you'll need for the course. If your class is partially in person, you'll still want to look through the Content tab. In either case, your instructor will let you know how they use content in D2L. In content, the left-hand side works like a table of contents in a book. It helps you find what you need. The first item is overview. Click on that to see if your instructor has put any important information that you need at the beginning. If you don't see anything there, just keep going. The second item is bookmarks. This is simply a place where you can quickly find material that you personally have bookmarked as you read it. So when you first begin, you won't see anything here. The third item is course schedule. Keep in mind that this particular link isn't necessarily your full course schedule, so don't rely on it for all of your assignments and due dates. Usually, instructors will post a document or a web page below for your course schedule in the table of contents. Be sure to find out from your instructor where you should be looking for the most detailed course schedule. So the place where you'll spend most of your time is here in the table of contents. Instructors will create modules to organize your class materials. There are two main methods that instructors use for organizing materials, and you'll want to familiarize yourself with which method is used. Method one is to organize the modules chronologically. This means that the first module you see is where you should start, and you will work through all of the materials in order, moving downward. Go through each and every content item you see in each module. Method two is to organize the modules by topic. If your instructor uses this method, then you'll want to look carefully at the title of each module so you'll know what's inside. Whether your modules are organized chronologically or by topic, you'll see the contents of the module once you click on it from the left-hand side. Sometimes you'll see what's called a submodule. A submodule is a separate module of materials that is nested inside of the main module. Look for submodules that might be indented within the table of contents. You can condense submodules using the arrows to the right. Remember, it's important to keep track of all of the materials in each module, whether it's a single content item or a group of items that are posted within a submodule. To make sure you've opened all of the items within a module, click on the main module title from the left-hand side of the table of contents. You'll see numbers to the right that tell you how many unopened items you have, and you'll see a check mark if you have completed all of the items in a module or submodule. Be sure to ask your instructor if you have any questions about the table of contents in your class, and thanks for watching.